generating the proximal distal axis of the limb. The apical ectodermal ridge, when mesenchymal cells enter the lymph field, they secrete the induces of overlying ectoderm to form a structure called the apical ectodermal ridge, or EER. The EER runs along the distal margin of the limb bud and become a major signaling center of developing limb. Progress zone or distal mesenchyme is often called the PZ progress zone. Mesenchyme, since the proliferative activity extends the limb bud, this interaction were demonstrated by the result of several experiments of the chick embryo. FGF in the induction on maintenance of the EER. FGF stands for fibroblast factor. FGF then is capable of inducing the EER in the competent ectoderm between the dorsal and ventral sides of the embryo, the boundary where dorsal and ventral ectoderm meets the critical to the placement of the EER. Specifying the mesoderm, determining the proximal distal polarity of the limb. If the EER is removed early stage wing bud, only humerus form. If the EER is removed slightly later humerus and reduced and ulna form. The Hox specification for the limb. The product of Hox gene have already played a role in specifying the location where the limb will form. Now, they will play a second role in specifying whether a particular mesenchymal cell will become a stylopod, zygopod, or autopod. Specification of the anterior-posterior limb axis in the zone of polarizing activity, or ZPA. The specification of the anterior-posterior axis of the limb is the earliest stage change from the pluripotent condition. Sonic Hedgehog defined the ZPA. A vertebrate homologue of the Drosophila hedgehog gene was expressed specifically in the region of the limb bud known to be the ZPA. Hox gene changes during development and formation of the ZPA. The limb bud has anterior-posterior polarity as soon as it is formed. The LEY3 transcription repressor is prominent in the anterior region of the limb bud, while the D-hand transcription activator is present in the posterior mesoderm, specifying digits of sonic hedgehog. Scientists were able to perform a scale fit mapping experiment in the SHH secreting cell of the generation of dorsal ventral axis. The third axis of the limb distinguishes the dorsal half of the limb, knuckles, nails, from ventral half, coordinating the three axes. The axes are used to maintain anterior axis. For instances, the sonic hedgehog in the ZPA activates the expression of the FGF4 gene in the posterior region of the EER. Cell death and the formation of the digits and joints. Cell death play the role in sculpting the tricuspid limb. Indeed, cell death is essential if our joints are formed and our fingers are to become separate. Limb development and evolution. The function first ascribed to MPs was the formation, not destruction, of bone and cartilage tissue. Continued limb growth, or epiphyseal plate. The ends of the long bones of humans and other mammals contain cartilaginous region called epiphyseal growth plates. The cartilage in this region proliferates so that the bone grows larger. CODA. FGF's protein generate the proximal distal axis of vertebrate limbs. SHH and BMPs generate the anterior posterior axis, and the WNTS appear to mediate the formation of the dorsal ventral axis.